In this episode of the Home Studio Show, I'm looking at Steinberg URC audio interfaces, Mixcraft 9 digital audio workstation, a new distortion from Waves plugins, N-Track Studio 9.1 update, free plugins, and much more. I'm Zane, and this is the Home Studio Show. This is a weekly show where I do audio tech news, reviews, and sometimes tips. Basically, I talk about the latest audio tech gear like audio interfaces and microphones. I also look at plugins, new and old, and digital audio workstations. Plus, I make sure to review free plugins in every episode. You can also download every episode as a podcast if you want to take me on the road with you, and you can go to thehomestudioshow.com to download that. You can also find it on iTunes. First up in news, Steinberg, the people behind the great digital audio workstation Cubase, they've released updated versions of their UR audio interfaces. And there are three audio interfaces in this new line. There's the UR22C, which is a two input, two output audio interface. Then there's the UR44C, which has six inputs, but you can only record four of them at the same time. And then there's the UR816C, which is 16 inputs. And of those 16 inputs, 8 of them are mic preamps. All of these interfaces have a rugged metal housing and offer 32-bit recording up to 192 kHz sample rate. They also claim to have super low latency and can offer faster transmission speeds to and from your computer thanks to the USB-C connection. You can even connect these audio interfaces to your iOS device. Be sure to check the link in the description for more information and pricing. Next in news, Acoustica's Mixcraft has been updated to Mixcraft 9. If you aren't familiar with Mixcraft, it's a digital audio workstation and they claim to have the best workflow, and they also say that it's the best in ease of use. Some of the new and notable features in version 9 include the addition of the voltage modular synthesizer that comes with 45 modules. You also get a new suite of over 10 plugins from Tone Boosters, Cherry Audio, and Acoustica. Another new and notable feature is you can convert audio tracks into MIDI. This is a very cool feature that can be done with the included Melodyne plugin. There are numerous other upgrades and features in Mixcraft 9. Be sure to check the link in the description for more information. There's a new distortion in town over at Waves Plugins, and if you were fortunate enough to take advantage of the Black Friday offer, then you'd have this plugin right now. Now, this new Waves plugin is called Berserk, and it claims to be a creative distortion plugin designed to inspire musical ideas. You get 10 original distortion shapes that have wildly different personalities, and if you can't decide which one you want to use, press the Go Berserk button, and it will randomize each distortion shape. You can throw this plugin on pretty much anything in your mix, and it will give your tracks new sounds that will stand out from the boring digital audio that's out there. If you're not familiar with Waves, they create some great professional quality plugins, and they offer them at very reasonable prices. Again, check that link in the description for more information on Berserk and the other Waves plugins. And more digital audio workstation news, N-Track Studio has been updated to version 9.1. And with this, you get over 10 gigabytes of royalty-free beats and loops, new tools like Vocal Tune, which is an auto-tune style tool, and you also get the new guitar and bass amp sims where you can simulate real-life gear. Again, the link is in the description if you want some more information on N-Track Studio 9.1. Please give this video a big thumbs up if you're enjoying it so far. And I've got that trivia question coming up in just a bit where if you answer it correctly, you'll get a shout out in the next episode. But right now we're going to move on to the plugins worth checking out section. And first up, I have Isotopes Trash 2. This is another creative distortion plugin that can be used on pretty much every track. You can use various modules in Trash 2 like delay and filters that give you a lot of options for coming up with unique sounds. One of my favorite modules in Trash 2 is the Convolve module. This models realistic amps, devices, cabinets, effects, and speakers. There are so many options here, and you can even load your own impulses into Trash 2. Plus, if you need some inspiration to get started, you can check out some of the 100 presets, which is what I'm going to do right now. And of course, you can check the link in the description for more information on Trash too. And now the next plugin worth checking out is Traction's Biotech 2. This is a very cool synth that uses natural and environmental samples to create its sounds. The interface is pretty cool. You can adjust this image in the center and take your sounds even further. It also includes over 500 patches to get you started. So let's give Biotech 2 a listen and check out some of those patches right now. Now, before we get to the free plugin section of the show, I have the trivia section. And last week, I had two people answer the trivia correctly. They were Innocent Bystander and Ronnie Kremer. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. And if you want to have a shout out in the next episode, be sure to answer this trivia question correctly. Name the song and the original band or artist from these lyrics. I'm bulletproof, nothing to lose, fire away, fire away. If you know the answer, be sure to put it in the comments below, and if you're among the first 10 people to do so, you'll get a shout out in the next episode. Now let's move on to the free plugins of the week. And the first plugin we're going to look at is a new one from Samplesynths, and this is called Push. This is a one-button generative synth for Mac and Windows, and every time you push the one button in the middle, it will create a new patch. You can further edit this patch in the edit panel, but if you're stuck for a sound, this can be a cool way to come up with some new ideas. So let's give it a try and see what kind of sounds we get when we push the button. Be sure to let me know what you think of Push in the comments below. And the next free plugin of the week is from a company called Senderspike. And this is their Signal Noise SNO2G VU meter. Now, a VU meter may look like a fairly simple plugin, but this one does offer some features in addition to the great analog meter looks. It can operate as a dual mono or stereo meter depending on your track. It has four fixed nominal reference levels for 0 dB VU. There's minus 12, minus 14, minus 18, and minus 20 dB. This can really help you in your gain staging. There's a switchable display of summed mono on both meters, left, right, or mid-side for stereo tracks only. Plus, there's some more features in there. If you have a free or paid plugin or any other audio software that you think I should check out in a future episode, be sure to let me know in the comments below. Now click up here for the Home Studio Show playlist, or click down here to see what YouTube thinks you should watch next. If you like this episode of the Home Studio Show, please give it a big thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more episodes. For the Home Studio Show and Simple Green Tech, I'm Zane, and we'll talk soon.